Artificial intelligence is all around us. Organizations in every industry are experimenting with AI models. They're also using more mature applications to capture business outcomes. AI has come a long way, but the journey is far from over. Who's better to talk about this than Bina Amanath and Kosti Perikos? How can we know the latest state of that evolution, Kosti, and where are business leaders on that journey?
Well, Kate, as you know, since 2017, Deloitte has tracked the way businesses use AI, and we've reported the results in our annual State of AI in the Enterprise surveys. Our fifth annual report this year has revealed that nearly all business leaders see AI as critical to their success now and in the coming years.
But what does success look like, Bina? And what are the approaches that can enable it?
We found that the current race with AI is no longer just about pilot projects, model adoption, or process automation. Instead, the emerging challenge for organizations is to prove return on investment. It's time to scale AI deployment for more far-reaching impact.
Bina, that sounds as if it's easier said than done. What is the most practical path forward?
That's a great question. Here are four actions businesses can take today to drive AI value at scale across their enterprise. AI at scale requires participation from stakeholders across the organization. It takes a diversity of people with a multitude of skill sets to drive AI development and deployment. These stakeholders need new skills and knowledge to use AI to its greatest potential. Now, how do we get there? What's needed is a business culture shift towards AI fluency. In such a culture, leaders communicate a bold vision for AI. They equip stakeholders with the education to understand AI function, the user-friendly AI systems that cater to a non-technical workforce, and the opportunity to contribute to AI design. Ultimately, it is a matter of change management. As we have found, organizations that make investments in these areas are more likely to meet and exceed their goals.
Success with AI takes more than just a powerful technology. The processes and the workflows that surround the AI lifecycle are just as important. And while many businesses continue to wrestle with transforming their operational practices, there are clear tactics that can mean the difference between high-value AI outcomes and underwhelming results. These include, as I suggested, tracking return on investment, documenting each stage of the AI lifecycle, and following MLOps procedures, what I call sort of professionalizing and industrializing the delivery of AI at scale in the organization. However, they also include AI risk management processes. AI-related risks can be significant, and organizations can look at ethical AI frameworks, for example, our Deloitte Trustworthy AI framework, to help identify the risks, address them, and importantly, drive better outcomes.
In this age of with, an era defined by collaboration between humans and machines, human talent is as vital as this advanced technology. Organizations are still experimenting with different talent and technology acquisition models, but one thing is clear: these activities need to be coordinated and planned in tandem. Businesses that are early in their AI journeys may look to hire professionals with AI skills, then only later focus on upskilling the existing workforce. Meanwhile, enterprises may pursue a diversified approach to technology acquisition, whether through purchasing off-the-shelf solutions, renting AI as a service, or building models in-house. Whatever the balance, the priority is for business leaders to carefully plan talent and technology investments so the caliber of the workforce matches the potential of the AI applications.
You know, valuable AI outcomes can fuel transformational momentum, but AI projects that come up short can really dampen the excitement and cause progress to stall. They can even drive what I would call an AI winter in an enterprise where people are just disillusioned. So when a business is starting out with AI, I think it's important that they go for use cases that are easier to achieve and can prove ROI very quickly. That will drive and catalyze the enthusiasm, but also show that AI is not just about enthusiasm, it can actually drive a return on investment in the business. And success with high value use cases can also make it easier to drive the cultural and organizational changes that are required to accelerate the benefits of AI. And what we're finding, the most valuable use cases will vary a lot between industry. And what we have done is, as you know, we've published the AI dossier that highlights across the various industries what we believe these really high AI value use cases are. And what's interesting is that many of them are not always at the front end. And I think people sometimes forget that it is those AI use cases that people don't see where a lot of value is driven. And so it's important to identify the quick wins that will be able to drive the biggest impact and the biggest return on investment in the AI journey.
Bina, when organizations take this advice to heart and act on it, what can they expect in return?
Wherever business strives, AI has the potential to carry it farther, faster. Making it work is more than a technology challenge. AI has implications for risk, change management, ethics, and culture. That means embracing AI has to work from the ground up with sponsorship and support from top down.
So for all the excitement we're seeing now, Kosti, it's really just the beginning.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I think we're at an inflection point where the business potential with AI is becoming near limitless, and the capabilities are evolving so fast. And of course, at Deloitte, we can help you keep up and seize the rewards in this age of human-machine collaboration for now and for the future.
Thank you so much, Bina and Kosti, for your thoughts.
It's great to be here. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate.